Hey guys, this is Ulrich from Nostalgic Mathematics. Today we will try to solve a problem from the German National Olympiad 2019. We are asked to find all the real solutions of the following system of equations. X equals 3 times x squared y minus y cubed, and y equals x cubed minus 3 times x y squared. At first glance, one might be intimidated, but I'm going to show in this video how to get away with a simple trick. So let's rewrite the system. Now we will focus on the right hand side of each equation. Two observations can be made. First of all, the exponents of x and y sum each order to 3. Indeed, 1 plus 2 equals 3, and 3 plus 0 equals 3. Also, the coefficients 3 minus 3, 1 minus 1 seem to be binomial coefficients up to a sign. That is, all the right terms look like the ones of a binomial development. So we apply Newton binomial formula for x plus y raised to the power 3. It gives us this outcome. But looking to the original right hand side, the signs are opposite for 3 times x y squared and y cubed. So one way to sort it out is to pass from y squared to negative y squared. Fortunately, this can be done using the complex number I. We just have to replace y by iy. So therefore, I will appear here and minus I appears here because I cubed equals minus I and y squared equals minus 1. Next, we rearrange the terms to identify both the real part and the imaginary part. Something is interesting here because this is the second right-hand side. And this is the first right-hand side. Therefore, replacing gives us a shorter equation. X plus iy cube equals y plus ix. In other words, we have derived an alternative form of the problem. Now, we build on the alternative form of the problem. X plus iy cubed equals y plus ix. You may have guessed it, we will perform a variable change. We set z equals x plus iy. Now, notice that this number as the same modulus as z. So applying the modulus here, we have modulus of z cubed equals modulus of z. Factorizing as this, we have either modulus of z equals 0 or modulus of z squared equals 1. But modulus of z squared equals 1 gives us two solutions, 1 and minus 1. But the letters ruled out because the modulus is always positive. So at the end of the day, we have two cases, modulus of z equals 0 or modulus of z equals 1. So let's dive into the first case. Modulus of z equals 0 means that z is 0 and therefore x equals y equals 0. And we have the first solution. Now we can turn our attention to the second case, modulus of z equals 1. What we want to do is that we will express this number in terms of z. Factorizing first by I, we see that y plus ix is I multiplied by the conjugate of z. Since modulus of z equals 1, therefore modulus of z squared equals 1. But modulus of z squared is z multiplied by the conjugate of z. And therefore, the conjugate of z is the inverse of z. And y plus ix equals I divided by z. But the same is equals to z cubed. So z cubed equals I divided by z. And z raised to the power 4 is I. We will write as this. And we know that it is a well-known equation. So z is the fourth root of this complex number. So we have four other solutions given as this. Rewriting in terms of real numbers, we have these forms of solution. Now we notice that between two consecutive solutions, the gap angle is pi over 2. So to simplify this, we're going to use a simple result. We know that cosine of t plus pi over 2 is minus sine of t. And the sine of t plus pi over 2 is the cosine of t. So globally, what we do here is that we switch the positions of cosine and sine with the minus here. So rewriting x1 and y1 as this. So for x2 and y2, we just switch the position with the minus. We do the same. We switch position and the minus. Again, we switch the position and the minus. And we have four order solutions. To sum up, we found these five solutions. But it would be interesting to compute the cosine of pi over 8 and the sine of pi over 8. You can do it using duplication formulas. So we have cosine of t over 2 equals the square root of 1 plus cosine of t divided by 2. And also the sine of t over 2 is the square root of 1 minus cosine of t divided by 2. In our case, we use t equals pi over 4 and the cosine of pi over 4, that is square root of 2 divided by 2. And this gives us the closed form of cosine pi over 8 and sine pi over 8. So replacing here, we have these solutions and we are done. Thank you for your attention. Again, do not forget to subscribe, like, and post your comments. Bye.